This election is a choice.
With federal elections in Canada just a week away, candidates of the major political parties are pulling out all the stops to woo voters. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau continues to campaign, even as two anti-vaccine protesters who were at his campaign stops have been charged. This includes the man who threw gravel at Trudeau. The Prime Minister's wife, Sophie Gregoire Trudeau, who's also campaigning, hinted at her concern for her husband's safety.
It's normal to have a human emotion of fear, but you should always follow through and move forward.
Mrs. Trudeau stomped for Filipino-Canadian Virginia Bremner, who's the Liberal Party bet in the Vancouver Kingsway riding.
No matter where you came from, no matter what anyone has told you, no matter how anyone has made you feel about being who you are, this great nation is built on the belief that we can be what we aspire and that we can achieve anything.
Mrs. Trudeau said the party has been pushing for more women in parliament and hopes that Bremner, too, will have her seat in Ottawa.
It's not an easy path, but knowing your strength and your courage and all that you understand of the people around you and all the help that is needed here in Vancouver and in the riding here is so important, and I'm very hopeful.
With more Filipinas running in this federal election, Consul General Maria Angelita Austria called on Filipinas to actively participate in Canadian politics and vote so that their voices can be heard.
Napakaganda pong pagkakataon para makapagpadala ng isa po sa atin na kinakatawan para magkaroon po tayo ng voice sa Canada. So, and we wish the candidates all the best.
Filipino-Canadian member of the Legislative Assembly Mabel Elmore, who was successfully elected twice, said she has been involved in the community for a long time before running for office. But Elmore explained that it was not just the Filipino vote that made her win.
I really have broad-based support from across the community, a lot of different community groups, unions, organizations.
The last time that Filipinos had a voice in Ottawa was during the time of Dr. Ray Pagtakhan of Winnipeg, who left Parliament in 2004. Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News, Vancouver.